everyone, I am Mukhtar. In this tutorial, I am going to present image classifier by using machine learning neural networks for medical or satellite images part 2. Note that part 1 of this tutorial has been presented previously. These are the title and the link of the part 1. In order to understand this part, you need to see part 1 first. Namely, this is a continuation of the part 1. However, here I would like to give a brief recap about the part 1. Let's see this picture. Steps in the image classification by using machine learning. Here, I have divided the whole process of the build on the neural network into several steps. See these steps. The steps from step 1 to step 8 have been presented in the part 1. Today, I will present the remaining steps, especially step 9 and step 10. In step 9, I restore the saved trained neural network. Then, in step 10, I validate the neural network by using practical data. In other words, this is a prediction process by using the trained neural network. Actually, in the end of the part 1, I have executed the code. This was the execution results. Let's see it. These are the epochs and the corresponding accuracies at set point of the training epochs. Epoch, corresponding accuracies. This is epoch and this is corresponding accuracy. This is the final training accuracy. The training seems to be fairly good and reached an accuracy rate of more than 93%. However, this accuracy is not satisfactorily good. Why? There are some reasons. First, I have taken less training samples for each output category. Second, since this is a tutorial, I used only single image for the training sample collections. In practice, multiple images should be used for the collection of the training samples. Thus, representative samples can be collected, so that classification accuracy should be increased as well. Third, I have set the training epochs very low for speedy training. It was 300 loops. In practice, this should be set properly. You should choose higher values. However, you may not choose a very high value. If so, it might be introduced the infamous overfit issue. In fact, the selection of the training rate and the number of training epochs are difficult to be defined. These parameters are defined based on trial and errors. So, the final classification accuracy is definitely affected by the samples and their qualities. However, in this tutorial, I am putting strong emphasis on the know-how about the topic. In addition, this is the accuracy history plot. It showed us the changes of the accuracy during the training process. Now, let's start to restore the saved trained neural network. Okay, this is the saved path of the saved trained neural network. I copy it from here, the last code execution, and paste it to here. I will use it later in this part 2. Now let's restore the saved neural network. Import NumPy as NP. Import TensorFlow as TF. From PIL import image. Import matplot.pyplot as PLT. From matplot import colors. Step 9. Restore the saved neural network. Save it, pause. Copy here. Paste. Paste it here. Okay. Then rest session equal to TF session. Saver equal to TF train import meta underscore grab and the pass. Copy the pass here. Add meta extension. Now we can restore the session. Rest session, save it, pass. Okay. We create. Great. prediction equal to TF augmax Y1. Step 10, validate the restored neural network. Okay, open an image, input data. IM NP array image open spot dot JPEG size shape. Now define output array for the classified image. Output data type float 32. Reshape it. Okay, now loop through the whole image. For Y in range size 0. For X in range size 1. Now we are going to get the vector equal to IM. Zero through size 2. Since we have 3 bands RGB. Prediction run underscore run equal to rest session run prediction and the feed dictionary X and give the vector. X underscore vec, and actually this is get the prediction. Output YX equal to prediction underscore run 0. Get the index of the maximum value. This is the index of the maximum value. This is the end of the loop. Now we are going to create a color map. Since we have 7 output categories, so we need 7 colors. See, gray, cyan, green, red, white, blue, and a navy. Okay, now display the classified, display the original and the classified image or result. Okay. So 1, 2, fig size equal to 14, 12. Okay. Im show IM. Set some title. Original image, then display the classified image or result. Imshow output with CMAP, color map. Then set some title, classified image. Okay, this is the end of the restore code. Let's see. Run it, what happens? Okay, restore. Okay, we get some error. Okay, here we fix it. Okay, we run it again and then restore it. Okay, now we are waiting. Okay, this is the classified result. However, we don't have title of the original image. We don't have title, so let's see, we have some errors. Okay, here it seems here 0. Okay, now run it again. Run again. Okay, now the restore it. The session is restored and it's running. Okay, this is the final classification result. Okay, this is original image, this is the classified image. or let's say corresponding places in both images. See here, corresponding places. See here, okay, this is, let's see here, okay, this is corresponding place, and let's see here, and this is corresponding classified image. Okay, see here, as well as here, and in classified image, see here. Okay. This is the final classification result, 93%, and this is the result. Okay, it's fairly good. So this is the code to restore the save it, train it, run it. Let's see. Okay, this is the code. You can find this code in the link in the YouTube video. This is the final result.